Hi, this is Dr. Justin here, and today's talk is on genetics. You are not a slave to your genes. We see all kinds of information in the news today about Angelina Jolie getting a preventative mastectomy, which is essentially removing healthy breast tissue. She tested positive for the BRCA1 and 2 gene. This is a genetic risk factor for breast cancer. The question I propose is, well, why are there millions of people out there that have this gene and aren't coming down with breast cancer? It's because genes are not a death sentence. You have the ability to control how your genes are expressed in regards to how you manage stress. So essentially, genes are like a light switch. You can flip it on or off based on how you manage stress. And it's the factors above the genes, known as epigenetics. These are the switches that are above. It's kind of like you see a puppet and the puppet moves, but it's the marionette above that's controlling the puppet. It's the epigenetics above that's controlling the DNAs, flipping it on and off. And many people in different families know that, hey, they have a predisposition to heart disease. You know, their father died of that, their uncle died of that. We see it with cancer in different families as well. And yes, we pass down lots of traits and skills through generations in regards to how to eat and manage stress and such. And these can play a factor in why these diseases are passed down. If we don't manage our stress properly, that turns on certain epigenetics, which flip genes on or off. So the next question is, how do we control these? So let's talk about that. So predisposition. Stressing our genes is nothing more than pulling the chain tight. Now each link in the chain may be a different predisposition. Heart disease here, multiple sclerosis here, cancer here, diabetes here. And if I pull that chain tight, the heart disease chain link may break on another, maybe the cancer on another, or fibromyalgia or MS on another person. So the question is, let's take the stress off the genes. Let's take the stress off the chain. Pulling this chain tight gives us the predisposition for these chain links to break. Lessening the stress decreases that chance. So essentially, we have three main stressors. These stressors can be physical, chemical, and/or emotional stressors. Physical could be an old car accident. It could be too much or too little exercise, old injuries, traumatic events, physical traumatic events. Chemical stressors could be infections, food allergens, eating poorly, getting exposed to environmental toxins or heavy metals. Emotional stress, poor communication in relationships, financial issues, issues with children or your spouse or loved ones. These are all issues that can affect the emotional side. And all of these stressors actually interplay on one another. So what that means is you may have hurt your back in an old athletic injury, an old sports injury. That's going to decrease your body's ability to function and do things like maybe golf or do things that you enjoy. Now you're going to have an emotional heartache now because you're not going to be able to do some of the things that you used to do. And then we're going to have all kinds of inflammation, which is a chemical stressor from the injury. So a physical stress becomes a chemical stress, which becomes an emotional stress. And then all of these stressors interplay on the genes. If we don't manage those stressors properly, then our genes are going to frown. We'll see a frowny face. If our genes are managed properly, we're going to see a smiley face. So the goal is we want to make our genes smile as much as possible. So getting back to our genetic predisposition analogy, our predisposition is which link may break. But again, if we don't pull the chain tight, we don't have to worry about the link breaking because the stress isn't on there to make it break in the first place. So manage the stressors by taking the stress off the chain, by taking the stress off your genes. You have the ability to control this. Going out there and preventatively removing healthy organ tissue, in my opinion, it's absolutely preposterous. A lot of people do it because they get caught up in the fear of it. They feel like they don't have control. They feel like it's a death sentence, and I want to make sure everyone knows that it's not a death sentence. You have the ability to control your genes. So in the analogy of Angelina Jolie and cancer, vitamin D is a perfect analogy that can decrease cancer risk amazingly. Decreasing sugar and refined carbohydrates, eating organic, managing stress, getting good sleep, moderate amounts of exercise, eating cruciferous vegetables, broccoli, asparagus, kale, they're high in these different cancer metabolizers. These are all simple things you can do that can basically take the stress off your genetic chain. So if this is your family, you have this chain right here wants to break, this is the breast cancer chain. and that happens in your different family here, just take the stress off it. Manage your stressors. And you may have to do a better job at that than the average person, but you still have the control. Hope you found this talk helpful. For more information, feel free to visit justinhealth.com and or call or email the office. Thanks. Have a great day.